Hey folks, this is going to be a very short video, and my plan is to show you how to use Desmos to plot sequences. So here are three sequences that we'd like to get a handle on. So there's 5 over n, ln of n, and 4 sine n. And we're going to use the same domain for each of these, which is going to be the set of natural numbers, or the integers n greater than or equal to 1. Now, Desmos is this wonderful online tool that everybody should know about. And the first thing we're going to enter to get our graphs of sequences, we're going to enter a list. So this list is going to serve as the collection of indices. And so if we just enter n equals and then use the syntax with square brackets, comma separated entries, and we'll the 1 comma 2 establishes the pattern of an arithmetic progression with difference 1. If we use the ellipsis dot 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 comma and then 100, what this command will do, it will create a list of arguments 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 100 in arithmetic progression. So this is a nice chunk of our domain, and so this list is going to serve as part of the domain of all of our sequences. So here's 5 over n. What we'll do is in a new cell, we'll enter the formula for A, and we'll use function notation, and we'll also use n for the argument for aesthetic reasons, although you could use x or t. This argument is a dummy variable, really. It won't matter when we plot this thing, but I used n. And I don't want the graph of the function itself. It'll be the graph of a continuous function, so I'm going to deselect the disk to turn that graph off, and then what I am interested in seeing is a collection of dots. So this ostensibly is the command to plot a point, the point n, comma a of n. But since capital N was entered as a list, this command induces Desmos to plot 100 points. It'll substitute the various values in that list. And recall, they were 1, 2, 3, all the way up to 100. So this is going to plot 100 different points using the formula a of n for the value. And so when you look back on your worksheet, you will see the first 100 terms of the reciprocal sequence 5 over n plotted in your Desmos worksheet. And you can see how this sequence seems to be converging to 0, and it's decreasing, and so on. So Desmos is a really handy way to fire up a graph of a sequence quite nicely. So by the way, if you want to make your picture look good, don't forget this wrench setting over here on the right. When you select that, you will get some options, including very powerful options to resize your window quickly. So you don't have to randomly zoom in and zoom out. And you can actually just set the X and Y dimensions very quickly to get a nice picture. All right, on to the logarithm sequence, ln of n. Same game, nothing new here, so I'll just use a different variable and plot this, and here we go. We get this nice increasing sequence, starts to level off, but we know that it actually grows without bound. We know this sequence actually diverges to infinity, but nevertheless, a beautiful picture here. 4 sine n, same story, and here we see chaos. So this sequence we know doesn't converge, doesn't diverge to infinity or diverge to infinity. It just kind of wobbles around randomly. It's just a divergent sequence. But here we get a very powerful way to fire up a plot of this sequence quickly. And finally, let's turn to some data. So here's soybean data, national soybean crop yield for a collection of years. And don't forget, you can always reset your index to be reasonable. So we don't want to use these 4-digit numbers for indices. So we'll let n be the years after 2000. So we'll reset these indices to be reasonable numbers. Now within Desmos, what we'll do for a small table like this is we will select this plus sign and select a new table. And filling in a table is rather self-evident. And you just plug in your data and boom, there you go. There's your soybean crop data. So have fun exploring sequences in Desmos.